here a transportation problem is given in a table. Okay, that is a company has four warehouses and four store here, and the cost coefficient are looks like in table, and these fours are the availability of four warehouses, and these four are the demand or requirement of four stores. Okay, and it is also given that the sum of availability is 80 and sum of requirement is also 80. So here we first write summation AI. This is the summation of availability. This is equal to summation of BJ. This is the summation of requirement. This is given as 80. So transportation problem is balanced. Okay. So here we use the method VAM, that is Vogel approximation method. We are going to find out the initial basic feasible solution of this transportation problem using the method VAM or Vogel approximation method. To use this method, we first draw a transportation table from the given problem, and we write each cost, that is 7355, in the corresponding cell, but the cost element write in the right lower cell, near right lower cell. Okay, and here are the availability and here are the requirement. These are four warehouses and these are four store. Now to use VAM, we first find out the penalties of each row and each column. How to find penalties? For the first row, to find penalty, first we find the lowest cost, and lowest cost is 3. Okay, and now we find the next lowest cost, that is next lowest cost is also 5. So we find the difference between the lowest and next lowest cost. This is given by 2. Okay, and this is the penalty for the first row. We write here the penalty for the first row here in a bracket. Okay, similarly here the lowest cost is 5 and the next is 6, so the difference is 1, so 1 is the penalty. And here lowest is 5, next is 6, so the penalty is 1. Here lowest is 6 but next is 4, so the penalty is 3. Similarly, we calculate all the penalties of column as, this is 4, 5, so this is 1, this is 6, 5, 6, this is also 1, this is 1, 3, this is 2, and this is 6, 5, 6, this is 1. Okay, so we calculate all the penalties. Now we find out the maximum penalty cell, sorry, maximum penalty row or column, and it is clear that this row contains the maximum penalty, which is 3. So this indicate that we have to allocate first in the fourth row. Okay, so to allocate in the fourth row, we first find out the minimum cost cell of the fourth row. What is the minimum cost cell? Clearly, this is the minimum cost cell because cost is 1, other than cost is 4, 6, 6. So we have to allocate in this cell first. Here, availability is 19 and requirement is 20. Okay, so here we allocate 19 amount because the minimum of 19 and 25 is 19. Okay, and we draw a straight line here and here also. Okay. Now here out of 25 unit we give here 19 unit, right? So we have to require another 6 unit, so we write here 25 minus 19, this is equal to 6, and this is as usual 21, this is 17, this is 17, and here is no available amount because 19 unit are allocated here. Okay, so we write here 12, so this is 15 and this is 34. and since the availability of this cell exhausted, so we cross off the fourth row. This is the symbol of cross off. Okay, this is the indication that this row has no call. This is the cross off row. Okay, now again we have to find out the penalties in the next iteration. Clearly, the penalty of this row is same. This is 2. This row is also 1. This row is 1. Here we do not calculate the penalties because this row does not exist here. Okay. Now we again to calculate the penalties of the column because one row is crossed off. So the new penalties is minimum is 5 and next minimum is 7. So penalty is 2. Minimum is 3, next minimum is 5, penalty is 2. 5 and 6, this is 1, and 5 and 5, this is 0. Okay, because least is 5 and next minimum is also 5. Now again, what is the maximum penalty? The maximum penalty occurs in 3 positions. Here in the first row, here in the second column, and in the first column. So there will be a tie case. And we can choose any one of row or column. Okay, whatever you may want. Here we take the first row. Okay, and here the available amount is 34. And the minimum cost in the first row, this is 3. So we want to allocate first here. But here only demand is 6 units. So we allocate 6 units. And clearly, by drawing the straight line, we write here 21, this is 17, this is 17, but this is nil because we already here allocate 6 unit. And here we write this is 28 because 34 minus 6, this is equal to 28. And this column is cross off. Because the demand of the second column is fulfilled, so we draw the symbol of cross off like this. Okay, again we calculate the penalties, new penalties, and clearly this penalty again 2 because this penalty is same. This is also 1, this is also 0, but in this side the penalty may be changed. We write first the availability 12. Now here next minimum is 5, sorry, lowest is 5 and next is 6, so penalty is 1. Next is 5, lowest is 6, penalty is 1. Here next, lowest is 5 and next is 5 also, so here penalty is 0. Now here again we get the maximum penalties at the first column. This is 2 maximum penalty. Now we find out the minimum cost cell of the first column, which is given by in the cell 5. Okay, this is the minimum cost cell because the cost is 5 and other cost is 7 and 8. So we want to allocate the allocation in this cell. Here the availability is 15 unit but demand is 21 unit. So we put here 15 unit here. Okay, and clearly this availability adjusted, and when this availability adjusted, then this row must be crossed off. And now here 21 is 21 fulfilled demand, but here required demand again is 21 minus 15, this is equal to 6. Okay, and this is 17, this is 17 as usual, and this is given by 28, and this is no available amount here, and this is 12. We may write here a cross sign, here also a cross sign, and here also a cross sign. Okay, to indicate there is no available amount of allocation or there is no demand. Okay, now again we calculate the penalty of each row and each column. Okay, and clearly the penalties of row are not changed here, so we write the penalty is 0 because 2, 5 here. We write the penalty is 1 because 5 and 6. Now the penalty of this column is 7 and 8, so the penalty is 1. Here 5 and 6, so the penalty is also 1. Here 5 and 5, the penalty is 0. Now the most penalty or maximum penalty occurs 1, which is this column and this row. We may choose again any one of row or column with maximum penalty. If we choose this row, then this is the minimum cost cell. Okay, and now here demand is 17 and available amount is 12. So we put here 12 and the availability of this row is exhausted. Okay, and the demand remains here is 5 units, and clearly this row becomes cross off now because availability is exhausted in this row. And we write the required availability or available amount is 28 here, and required demand is 17, and here the demand is 17 and here is 6, and this is not 17, this is 17 minus 12. We already fulfilled the demand 12 unit, so this is 5 unit. Okay, now in this stage it is clear that the company have only one option. This is one warehouses are demands. That is the first warehouses, and the available amount is 28. And demand from three store, that is three requirement, this is 6, 17 and 5. And it is shown that the demand of three required amount is equal to the available amount in the first warehouses. It is obvious because this is a balanced transportation problem. So we directly allocate 6 unit here, 17 unit here, and 6 unit, sorry, 5 unit again here. Okay, and availability is exhausted and requirement is also fulfilled. And this is the process of Vogel approximation method. Now to check, it is initial basic feasible solution. To check it basic, we first count the number of allocation. The number of allocation is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, and right here number of allocation. Number of allocation is equal to 7, and we write its as 4 plus 4 minus 1, because we know that in a basic feasible solution there must be m plus n minus 1, m plus n minus 1 number of positive allocation. Okay, so we say that obtained solution is basic solution. Clear? This is the first point. And we already said that in any method of transportation problem, we only find the initial basic feasible solution, not optimal basic feasible solution. Okay? So we say that Initial basic feasible solution is. Here we write this is x11, this is 6 unit. Okay. x12, this is also 6. x13, this is 17. x14, this is 5. Because this is 5. Now x21, this is 15, and x42, this is 19, and sorry, here we want x 3 4. X 3 4, this is 12. Okay, this is the initial basic feasible solution of the transportation problem by using Vogel approximation method. Okay, very very interesting and important method to solve or to find initial basic feasible solution of a transportation problem. Thank you for watching.